next one I want to show you is, I know, but I think you all know Premiere. I captured with OBS Studio your performance here. I don't use it for something else. I only use it now for demonstration to show you also the recorded performance in the beginning, I think so, with Andrea. So it's also, again, it's material. So always try to record what you are doing when we are working together, also with Andrea. And also try to record it again from MS Teams or from another capture program you use. So therefore we can also think again about what happened, look at ourselves, see ourselves moving and trying to understand what Andrea was trying to tell you or to give the inputs to you. This is also now possible with Premiere to cut it in pieces, take this piece, take it, leave it, take it here, and make a collage, a montage out of this footage. You can also scale in, cut this out, and maybe work with only one view of this screen. Also Premiere, who never worked with Premiere, this is the main window of Premiere, the cutting window, the timeline. Here is the viewer. You can always see timeline and viewer together. Here are all the possibilities to, or toolings to manipulate the content on the timeline. It's here. You can rotate it. We can scale it. We can change the position of the whole video. We can hear the audio level. We can change it, but we have no audio recorded now. We have also the opacity here. We can say, we make a blender here. And all of this traditional film producing tools are packed into this software. You also have a lot of effects here where you can manipulate your content by some effects here. Or it's also nice to work in a post-processing process to change the color also. There are some color profiles here from the Alexa, from the Ari, you can suddenly change also the contrast and the style, the look of your content. This is really a really rough and short introduction into Adobe Premiere. I think who wants to work with video content and with video pieces has to be nearly professional in Premiere, but it's not so complicated. Another program we also talked today is Resolume Avenue. You see now the window of Resolume, and it's fantastic. I will clear this again. I can have here my sources. And sources, you can see my capture devices. I can use now Manicam. It's here. Drag and drop it into also here the sort of timetable. Click on it. And now I have the real-time content of Manicam. I can also change it to our MS Teams viewer now. And can transform it also real time here with effects. I can have this Dr. Bieber distortion effect. And when you click here on this button, you can arrange or connect the audio input to your video stream. And now let's try to make a BMP sync. Now it's connected to my voice, to my sound, body of speech. So my body is speaking, my mouth is speaking, my voice is something like an electronic wave. And with my voice, I manipulate real time the content now from our MS Teams window. This is really fantastic. And you can also combine it now with different layers. You see, you have the layer 3, we have the layer 2. There are some footage videos from Resolume inside the program you can use. And now I have 3 layers, 1, 2, 3 layers, and have this mixture of some technoid visuals, club visuals, and on the top layer, the visual of our own stream here. So we can real-time manipulate, capture, and play with the input. This is really great with Resolume. We can also record this. So in the end, we can record this mixture of our live stream, have a video again, and can use this video again in Premiere to cut it, to play with it, to make a montage. And the last program is this 3D Sapphire. It's a really nice program. It's the program where you can produce photograms, 3D photograms from videos or from stills. I show you the way how it mainly works. We have to go here to this process, new project. Then you have to choose 3D model, texture, and mask the picture. I say okay. Now you have to window to choose the content from your computer, where is the path to your video or your pictures. I use a video now, importiere Bilder aus Video, import pictures from video. I have something on my computer here on D, body of speech. There should be something inside. Where is it now? Ciao. I think I have it somewhere else. Here. So, body of speech. So I have my left hand here or my face. I think with this face, it's not working so good. Left hand, let's try it. I only captured this for, I think, 45 seconds or 30 seconds, because for the free version, it's only possible to use 50 pictures. And when you have 30 seconds, you can use 1.5 pictures, frames per second. So in the end, you have something like 45 pictures. You also have to choose the path where the program has to capture again the stills. I also have to change again. Body of speech, photogram, hand, and let's make a new one here. Probe and start frames, extract the frames and import them into the workshop. Now the program is running, is exporting these 50 frames. You see it lasts a little bit, and in between we can switch again to Resolum and see some of other possibilities here. So it's clear now. We can also have a rainbow palette here. So we change the colors. We can have the mode here also, BMP sync. Now it's changing the colors in correlation or synchronizing with my voice. Also interesting, or with the timeline here. So let's go back to 3BC file. Still working. Has every one of you downloaded and installed all of these programs, or most of them?
Yes,
okay. So after this breakout session now, this come together, you have 2 hours time to think about your concept a little bit, if it's possible at this time now, to make you a little bit common with the software, to try also to make a photogram with these photogrammetry programs, or to find also a way with the input of Andrea to work with the camera, near camera, wide angle camera, where is the camera, where is the viewer, what do you want to see, and to work also with your own body in this way. So let's come into a working modus, because this is the main and the most difficult part of doing art, to get into a moving modus, to do or to make art, not to sit and think and always think about making something better. This is not the right way to do it. You only can find your own art and art pieces by doing it. So please be motivated and have enough energy for the next 2 hours to come into this working mode. And after this working session, at around 4:30, we will come together again and make a summary about your inputs. So please prepare yourself for this small, simple summary for today. We need your inputs. So now you see the program has collected now 45 pictures, I think, so it's in a row. Yeah, 46. It's okay. Passed. Okay. Then here you can decide between near field, when you have a drone and picture from above, when you have a huge scene like a city or an architecture, or if it's an human body. Let's state the normal modus, and here you can decide if it's fast, standard, or really deep, a little bit longer when you say you want to have it deep. And next again, also here, deep. Next again, deep. Next again, and now start the process. The program is now trying to convert the information of the two-dimensional video into a three-dimensional space. Often it's totally glitchy. It's something totally else. Maybe also now, because I captured my left hand with the camera. Maybe I moved the hand too much, because when you capture the hand, it should stay still. And so I think we will have in the end a glitchy artifact, a 3D object, which combines space and time of this situation of my hand. I think it will last around 2, 3, 4 minutes, because it's a lot of computing, of processing for the computer. First, he tries to understand the angels, the complexity, to arrange the cameras. Then he is merging a cluster field. Most of our time, of our lifetime, is looking into screens or at screens and watching programs by doing their programming. This is also a strange situation we are living in when we are a media artist or creatives working with this complex technology. But it's also okay, because in between we can think and have our brain and find maybe other solutions than the computer in its programming world is giving us. So you see, now he has all the pictures here as a storyboard or frame by frame, as a timeline. And he's now calculating, or it is calculating. The computer is, I think, an it, the point cloud. You see it here. Also lasts again 1, 2 minutes. And we can also try to bring this now into our Manicam, if we want to. Let's see if it will work. Input. Maybe let's put this Resolume inside here. I hope it works, yes. So we have Resolume here, and also we put here 3D Sapphire into this window. This one. So now we have this window, and it's funny, now we have this endless effect, because I put Manicam inside. This was wrong. I want 3D Sapphire. Let's do it here. Okay. And this window again, we put into Resolume. Here you see it. And this is really funny. It's an endless machine we have now. We can transfer, record, manipulate, play, arrange, montage, our real-time content. I think it crashed now, my machine. It was too much. It's too much on board now. I have too much fuse, too many fuse around, going around. So MS Teams shut down suddenly. Can you hear me again? Am I here?
Yes.
So this was a real-time breakdown. You can also play with this. How many streams can be put together at the same time? Also interesting as an art question, maybe. This was live now, this crash. So I will stop now some programs here. Let's share it again. Let's try it again. So again, into Resolum here. And here are now 3D Sapphire. It's working. Plus, you see. And what is maybe a good input again from the art history? Bruce Nauman here. Let's watch Bruce Nauman in the 60s in his New York studio, where he always thought about what is the material for art, of art, and what do is a need for art. For him, it was only the space, the body, and some lines he draw on the floor of his studio place. He draw these squares, or pictures these squares, and then he follows the line, tries to perform, not in a normal way going, but going slow, going by putting your hip down, up, really concentrated. These are also one of the most famous video art pieces in video art history. Bruce Nauman himself, one of the most expensive artists, living artist. Now he is in the 70s or 80s, getting older also, like we all. But this is a few and a wonderful demonstration of an artist trying to find a way to cope with time and space. Maybe it's also for us now boring. For many people, when you show them these pieces, they think, what is this? What is going on? But this is art. This is the question always from an artist who is in his studio trying to find a way to produce something what is called art. I like Bruce Nauman a lot. We have another videos here in this role. When you have time, please feel free and go into the material. We have time also in the week of the workshop. We always have also some views inside one of the videos, but there are so many videos compacted here now that it's a archive also for you for after the workshop or in between the workshop when we are not together. So let's go back to Sapphire. So again, the program is working. So it needs time. We have to be patient also when we do this. So I will go back to you now. When it's ready, we can look again into the Sapphire. So was this understandable? Could you follow me?
Yes, everything is clear.
Yes. So also try to combine the content, the ideas in combination with these software tools, but not only with this, what I show you, also again to mention this, that also work with software you are normally used to also, where you feel comfortable. In the end, there was also a question today, what will be the result in the end? Hopefully, everyone has a piece of art in a way of animation, a video piece, audio video piece, or maybe a 3D object. But the question is, how can we share this object in the whole presentation? But as it was mentioned today, there is one alumni student, she is preparing a big virtual exhibition space where it's also possible to share 3D objects. So let's work on this idea to generate video pieces, in the end, one or maybe more, like a work in progress also. Video pieces, audio visual pieces, with the body speaking, a voice and body in space with this topic, and also to work on this idea of building three-dimensional object spaces with this, again, with this idea of body and space. This would be great if we can reach this goal, or everyone could reach this goal. So we have now this 3D object. I can share it again. So let's try. This is it now. It's really a glitchy. It should be my hand here, but you can see the skin. But it's not recognizable as a hand. I moved it too much. This was the problem, I think so, yeah? When I show you the video, the original video, I hope I can find it. Yes, this is the video here. So again. So this is the video. Can you see it?
Yes, we can.
Yes. Mm-hmm. 30 seconds. With the camera, with the handy camera, trying to find different angels. But maybe this was a better piece because I also did one, a photogrammetry of this also before I open it. Oh, it was this example, yeah. So it's an object now. It's a landscape or something we can call a landscape also. In a 3D or in a virtual space, it could also be a landscape for a game, for something else. When you are totally into the landscape, it's a microscopic, but also a gigantomanic landscape. Walking around with the headset here inside would be also an interesting process. But in the end, it's only a small piece of my hand glitched by the 3DC file. So let's be also prepared that not every 3D photogrammetry process will result in a perfect match. Often it results also in this glitch world artifacts. But I think this is also interesting from the side of body of speech, because here the software tries to interpret the reality and speaks, or this gave us back as an answer, a totally glitched new interpretation of reality.